It's time to play everyone's favorite game show, How British Are You? And here's your host, Septimus!
Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, are you ready to play How British Are You? Before we begin, let's go over the rules for those playing along at home. The object of the game is to correctly answer the definition of each British phrase. The victor is given 10 seconds to answer each question, but if you're playing along, feel free to pause the video and take as long as you wish. The scores will be tallied up at the end of the game, and to see how well you did, check the scoring system listed in the information box below. Are you ready to play? How British are you?
I am indeed. I am determined this week to make sure that I'm going to at least try not to be the dog's bollocks, but I'm probably still going to be the dog's bollocks.
Well, let's get started then.
All right.
Question one. What is an aubergine?
A what?
An aubergine.
An aubergine?
Yes.
Oh my god. I'm going to say it's an apple.
That is incorrect. An aubergine is the correct name for eggplant.
Well, I was kind of close in the sense that like it was an actual like fruit or vegetable. I have no idea what that is. That is you British people, you are certainly things over there.
Question number two. If I was asking for the bill, what would I be asking for?
I'm going to say you're asking for, the ticket.
What do you mean by ticket?
Ticket as in you're asking for, like, the playbill, like, of a play or something.
That's incorrect. If I was asking for the bill, I would be asking for the check in a restaurant.
Oh. See, now I second-guessed myself out of that one, because that's an American term as well, and I thought, okay, well, this has to mean, like, a horse's, like, left shoe or something like that. I know what the bill is, but I didn't know that it was literally going to be the American version, because the American version is, whatever. Fine. The Canadian judge is throwing stuff at me now. He's throwing maple leaves at me, so fine.
Question number three. If I put blinds up, what would I be putting up?
Putting blinds up. You're just talking about curtains, aren't you?
Sort of.
Well, then you're talking about the under. It's basically blinders. I don't know what else to call it. Like shades. Like you.
That's correct.
Okay, shades. There we go.
Question number four. What is a bonnet?
A bonnet.
Yes.
A bonnet is just a fancy hat, isn't it?
That is correct, but not what I was looking for.
Well, what were you looking for?
You would refer to it as the hood of the car.
Okay, well, wait a second. So does my answer...
Your answer is correct,
okay.
Yeah, so I'll give you that.
Okay. But not
I
the answer...
I forgot that it was a hat.
Yeah, I know what a bonnet... I've never heard of the bonnet as in, like, the hood of a car, but... Canadian judge, what do you say? Okay, he's gonna give it to me, so yeah, there you go. 2 for 4. Take that, Septimus.
Question number 5. If I had a boot on a car, what would it be?
Boot on a car. That's the apparatus that tow truck companies or ticketers use to lock up a tire.
That is incorrect.
What?
The boot of a car is a trunk.
Trunk of a car is called a boot?
Yep.
Well, how did we come from that language? Whatever.
Question number 6. What are braces? And I don't mean the ones that go on teeth.
Braces are what you put on legs to make them straight.
No, I'm afraid not. Braces are what you would call suspenders. Question number 7. What is a bum bag?
Now, come on. You're just making these up now.
No.
A bum, as in B-U-M-B-A-G.
That's correct.
Oh my god. I'm just gonna say a seat, I don't know.
That's incorrect. It's a fanny pack. Because for some bizarre reason, you Americans call bums fannies.
Oh, God. Alright, well, two for... I don't even know how much I'm out now, but I'm already locked into... I have to get past Pillock. I can't be a Pillock, that's for sure.
Question number 8. What is casualty?
Casualty. I'm just gonna say... A dead pet. I don't know.
That is incorrect. Casualty is an emergency room.
The ER is actually called a casualty.
Called casualty. There's no V in it. Question number 9. All what right. are chips?
Chips is in like C-H-I-P-S, right?
Yes.
Okay, that one I do know because I happen to love chips. In both senses. They are your weird term for French fries.
That is correct.
Yay! At least I know the food ones, kind of, except for the... What was the the scrumping? Yeah, that one was weird.
Scrumping is an honorable pastime, okay?
Stealing apples is an honorable English pastime. Got it.
Question number 10. What is cling film?
Cling film. Cling film? I'm gonna say dryer sheets.
That is incorrect. Cling film is plastic wrap.
Oh, actually that does make sense now. 3 for 10, so Septimus, what am I again for this week?
Once again, Sinvicta, you are the dog's bollocks.
Yay, that's... Thank you. I appreciate it. At least I've got the consistency streak going, so. Thank you for watching this episode of How British Are You? Of course, you can find all the links to Septimus and Delta Squid down below in the info box. And remember, every single Monday is a brand new episode of How British Are You? So thank you again for watching. Hope you had a fantastic day. And of course, I will see you all next time. So long, everybody.